Hello all. I am Dr. Madhupa Patil, a dental graduate who is passionate about restorative and minimal invasive dentistry. I have been into evidence-based dental practice called Smile Creations in this iconic Mumbai for more than a decade. Before we start, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all my mentors for their unending support and motivation. And not to forget, thank you Team Colting for offering me such a wonderful opportunity. Topic for today's webinar is Compo-Tooth Synergy, where we will be discussing how to gel up composites with natural tooth elements. We will also talk about the innovative duo shed concept of Synergy Basics. So let's go ahead. I strongly believe nature is the best teacher. If one understands the natural tooth elements, it becomes easy to achieve predictable restoration. Here in the cross section of the tooth, we can appreciate thin translucent enamel and thick, slightly opaque dentin. Dentin majorly gives the shade of the tooth. Enamel reflects the dentin canvas beneath. While restoring any cavity, always think which and how much tooth element has been lost due to the caries. In a simpler way, the lost dentin has to be replaced with the appropriate dentin shed composite and the lost enamel to be replaced with the appropriate thickness of enamel composite. Synergy D6 composite system is the exact system which can fulfill all needs in a simplified manner. It consists of dentin duo shed and two enamel shades. Dentin shades covers a wide range of tooth shades with fewer syringes. System has only two enamel shades, universal enamel, which is a highly translucent surface layer composite to improve gloss and to restore incisal edges. It can be used in the elderly patient where the enamel is thin and translucent. It would easily reflect the dentin shape beneath. White opalescent is used in creating the natural depth appearance. It can be used for building up incisal edges of very light or bleached teeth or in younger patients. But now question comes, why duo shades? Let me explain. Here in this slide, you can see the Vita shade guide, which is arranged according to the value of shade. Synergy D6 is value-based system where two shades of nearly same value are combined into one duo shade syringe. Now people ask, why value-based? Remember, if value goes wrong, that's an aesthetic failure. What new in this Synergy D6 composite? It's a nano-hybrid composite, which means superior physical properties, superior polish retention, and enamel like wear. What do we look while selecting a composite system? Good handling, non-sticky nature, non-slumping, and it should be easily sculptable. It should not easily fracture or wear. It should mimic the optical and color properties of the natural tooth. It should not stain, means it should be color stable. It should be easily polishable, should have gloss retention. It should be radio opaque. It should have all shades required into your practice and also simplified shade selection. It's one system for anterior as well as the posterior restoration. Means it's for my everyday dentistry. For me, yes, it should be available in compules and syringes. I prefer compules in my practice for these reasons. It's easy to dispense in cavity directly. Pressure exerted while dispensing gives you an auto condensation force and quick adaptation of composite to the cavity. It also flows gently under pressure to enhance easy handling and precision application. There are no chances of air entrapment in your restoration. You can simply rotate the angled composite compule into the desired position. So difficult to reach areas are easily accessible, like your upper molars. No worries of contamination in this COVID era. Can be warmed before using an injection molding technique. Here is a small video on how to use the compules with the dispenser gun. This is a dispenser gun. You can fit the compule into the dispenser gun. After removing the cap, press the piston of the gun. The composite is slowly extruding from the compule. You can simply rotate the compule to the desired position to reach the difficult to access areas into the patient's mouth. One more unique thing about this system is their nesting shade guide. It has made the shade selection more easier, faster, and yet predictable. Shade tabs are made up of Synergy D6 composites itself. Hence, you can compare the post-cure final look of dentin enamel combination. There is no wastage of material unlike in shade button try technique. You can see various enamel and dentin combination immediately. So no need to keep multiple customized shade guides. Here's a short video on it. These are the available dentin shades and the enamel shades. For the shade selection, do a quick run through of dentin shade tabs near the body of the tooth. Here we are cross-checking it with the Vita shade guide. So we have selected A2B2. Dentin shade tab. Then time for the enamel shell selection. So we have found the universal enamel shell to be matching to the Vita shade tab. Now here's the magic. Dab the dentin tab with a drop of water and slide the enamel shell over the dentin tab. And here you can see the final dentin enamel combination. You can also appreciate that the same combination is going well with the two shades of Vita shade guide. Synergy D6 Flowable is a perfect complement to all other Synergy D6 products. The formula of Synergy D6 Flow is based on the same technology of Synergy D6. The consistency of the Flowable provides flow on demand, means material will flow only under pressure. It can be used in the tiniest cavities. It can also be used as a bio-based or adaptive layer beneath the composites. It can also be used as a shock absorber layer, can be used for minor corrections and minor composite repair. It has reduced shrinkage value, so it can be used for the tiny restoration also. Let's see the stepwise protocol for class 4 restoration. As we all know, upper central incisors are more prone to fracture. After the proper pulpal and periodontal evaluation, we should decide the restorative treatment. Let's go ahead. The use of silicone index in anterior composite is always do a fit check of index. Relieve any interferences if present. Protect the adjacent teeth with the depths of matrix bands for accidental burr ditches, etching or bonding. For creating a seamless restoration, we need to blend composites to the natural tooth. For that, we need a bevel magic. Here you can see two bevels. One is a shorter bevel, which is very much near to the fracture margin. It's nearly 45 degrees. This is the area where your dentin composite should extend. The second one is the long bevel, which is 10 to 20 degrees and is in a wavy pattern. This is the area where your enamel composite will end. The bevels can be prepped with Dietech torpedo burr. Finishing and smoothing of the margin is done with the help of Swiss-like disc. This helps in seamless restoration and prevention of wide demarcation line post-restoration. Selective etching with 37% orthophosphoric acid is done with the adjacent teeth protected by Teflon. Thorough washing of etchant is mandatory, otherwise it interferes in the hybrid layer and demineralized dentin, which can lead to post-operative sensitivity. There are hundreds of adhesives available in market, so people are confused how to select the good one. We should select the right product followed by the right technique. Here I have used 1-foot-7 universal adhesive. It can be used as no edge, selective edge and a total edge. It has MDP and 4 meta molecules. MDP is a phosphate monomer and is mainly used as an etching monomer. It improves the adhesion to enamel, dentin and metal alloys. 4 meta, it is a silane coupling agent which is capable of diffusing through demineralized surface to promote the formation of hybrid layer after the polymerization. Look for the silicon key adaptation. Trim off the excess of index near to the clamps and the gingival papilla. Always verify correct insertion and stability. Then mark the extent of the fracture line on the key with the help of sharp explorer or fissura instrument. While restoring a fractured teeth, we usually start from the palatal wall. When we have a silicone key ready, apply enamel composite homogeneously over the silicone key till the mark line. How much thick should this palatal enamel shell be? It should be nearly 0.3 to 0.5 millimeter. Isn't it difficult to measure this thing? So just a small trick. Enamel composite layer should make one shade lighter of that putty index. While developing the proximal walls, maintaining the contour of the tooth with proper contact area is important. Proximal walls can be built up with enamel composite and with the help of contoured metal matrices, which are stabilized with the wedges. By building up the palatal shell and the proximal wall, we get a ready template for the further composite layer. Remove the excess flash of composites with the help of 12 number blade or Swiss flex disc or red ring diamond burr at low speed without water. This helps us to achieve well-defined clean perimeter. The center picture is of the incisal aspect of the palatal shell. Application of opaque layer is done to block the show-through effect. How much opaque layer thickness should be? Less the better. If you want to create a translucent incisor edge, avoid loading opaque composite at the incisor edge. If you want to create a halo effect, apply a thin strand of opaque composite at the incisor edge. Then comes my dentin composite layering. Apply dentin composite over the opaque composite. The composite should be loaded and blended nicely till the short bevel. As we all know, dentin body thickness is the major concern for achieving right color. Less of dentin means the thick of enamel, thus a gray or translucent restoration. Excess of dentin means a very thin enamel and thus opaque restoration. So how to achieve the exact thickness of the dentin? There is a simple way to obtain 0.5 enamel accurately with little effort. The dentin composite is placed in one sole increment and is not polymerized. Then with the help of Mishura instrument, the excess of dentin is carried away from the restoration by leaning the thin part of instrument on the sound tooth and letting the thick part of the instrument press against the unpolymerized dentin composite, thus pushing away the excess. After achieving the right thickness of the dentin and before polymerization, with the help of explorer and fissura, remove the dentin composite from incisal edge and the proximal wall area. Also at this stage, you can start building up your mamelon and vertical striation. For extra incisal translucency, you can add blue tint from Myris on the incisal edge and little in between the mamelon, and the white opaque from Myris on the mamelon for more enhanced look. Now what does these tints do? They give 3D effect to your teeth. Finally, this is a perfect space for my enamel composite. So here we can start for your enamel composite layering. Finally, the enamel composite is placed in bulk increment till the long bevel. Because of already calibrated dentin, our work here consists only as following the contour of the tooth. This 0.5 mm of enamel will give a very correct translucency and opacity, making the restoration look very natural and integrated at the marginal level. The final polymerization of the composites for long 30 seconds should be done in the presence of KY jelly so as to prevent the formation of soft, cheesy oxygen inhibition layer. No composite restoration is complete without finishing and polishing. Contouring of the tooth is started by marking line angles with a sharp pencil. These markings indicate the bulges of the angle. So contouring is done by creating slopes adjacent to the marked line angles. It has to be done with a sharp red ring diamond burr at a low speed, that too without water. Finishing is started with the disc. Discs are ideally suited for the interproximal and the labial polishing. This is a silicone wheel called Dietech Shapeguard Pre-Polisher. It has to be used at 10,000 to 12,000 RPM with water, giving minimal and constant pressure. Polishing is done by Dietech Shapeguard High Lustre Polishers at 10,000 to 12,000 RPM with water and under minimal and constant pressure. At this step itself, you will achieve a natural looking surface with superior gloss. This little cotton buff will really do a great job for you. One can use it with a tiny amount of diamond polishing paste. One can achieve predictable, natural, functional and the long lasting results by following this simple protocol. Isn't it easy? The key to beauty and the biologic integrity of long-term restorations lies in the final steps of the procedure, and that's finishing and polishing of the restoration. Highly polished surface is more biologically compatible with the gingival tissues, so the gingival health is maintained. It also significantly lowers the risk of secondary caries and periodontal disease. It also ensures longevity and durability of the restoration. Finishing and polishing enhances patient's comfort and satisfaction. Patients greatly appreciate the natural beauty of your restoration. With the pursuit of taking finishing polishing of composites to the higher level, Coltine has introduced a new Diatec all-in-one composite finishing polishing kit. It consists of diamond burrs of different grits for gross finishing. I can simply vouch for this white ring superfine diamond burr for getting beautiful scratch-free palatal and lingual surface. The second set is the carbide burrs. Basically, always remember, diamond burrs abrade the surfaces. That means you get a scratches on the surfaces, and the carbide cuts the surface. Hence, you achieve a smooth surface. So the scratchy effect created by the diamond burrs should be smoothened with the carbide burrs. The third set is the superfine Kenda polishers, which are made up of silicone. There are four different shapes. It can be used according to the area to be addressed. The fourth is a silicone carbide embedded polishing brush. Let's see how this system works. I believe in evidence-based dentistry. So here some of my clinical cases done with composites. So this is a case where the middle-aged lady came to us with a fractured 1-1. After proper endodontic treatment, a composite veneer was done. And here's the before-after images. A tiny class 3 along with spacing in between 1-1 and 2-1 is restored with the composite. This was an orthodontic relapse case. Case was completed with only addition dentistry. It's an additive composite case. Patient came to our practice saying that, "Doc, I don't like my colorful teeth. Can you make them in one shot?" And yes, we did it. This one is my favorite one. I enjoyed creating the halo effect, translucency in the central incisor. Finally, the posterior restoration, everyone's bread and butter, classic class 1s and classic class 2s. With this, I would like to conclude my session. Thank you all for watching my presentation patiently. For queries, you can connect with me on this email ID.